Hello viewers, welcome to this video on shear wall. So in this video we shall be discussing the functions of the shear wall, its types and behavior to some extent. The general definition of shear wall goes like this. Shear wall is a vertically oriented planar structural element primarily designed for resisting lateral load in its own plane. So it does not primarily resist any vertical load, but it resists horizontal load, and that is true as a resistance in its own plane. Let us understand this through a figure. So here is a shear wall shown. An earthquake takes place from this direction, from left to right here in this figure, and a resisting force as shown here is acting on the opposite direction. So this resisting force is acting in its own plane, in the plane, vertical plane of the shear wall. So that is the meaning of the resisting in its own plane. So this is called the in-plane action. The action is in the same plane as that of the earthquake load, which is acting in the vertical plane. Now, there can be also out-of-plane action, because the force can act also from the other direction perpendicular to the surface, this surface. So in that case it is like this and it is bending. So this is called out-of-plane bending. And as a result, there can be cracks developed on the outer side out of tension. What happens? The system is very strong in the in-plane action, but it is very weak in the out-of-plane action. So a shear wall can be subjected to earthquake load either from in its own plane or also in the out-of-plane direction perpendicular to the plane. But this can be avoided by considering shear wall in the perpendicular direction in the plane of the system, so that from wherever measured direction the earthquake comes, there shall be a wall to resist it. Now let us see the functions of the shear wall. It carries lateral load arising out of earthquake or wind. It protects the system, the building, from rain, sun, theft. It provides extra rigidity to the building. So what is the advantage of extra rigidity? The extra rigidity will reduce the deflection in the building. And as you know, the damage occurs due to large deflections, so it will arrest the damage thereby. It dissipates large amount of energy absorbed from earthquake through hysteresis. So this hysteresis we shall take up in some other video. So some damage happens in this wall, generally at the bottom of the wall, and it will dissipate a lot of hysteretic energy through bending action, through flexure. Now let us see the shear wall as a structure. Shear wall is basically a cantilever beam fixed at the base and free at the top. So we have shown a column here which is fixed at the base and free at the top. A cantilever also analogous to this, with only exception there it is very wide in its length. So from here to here is called the length of the wall, and particle dimension is the height of the wall. And load is acting at the top of the wall, and it is resisting the load in its own plane. So when it is resisting its own plane, it is bending like this. It is bending towards right. This middle figure is bending towards right in the particle plane, and that is what is approximately shown by this diagram. As a result, a lot of tension will be developed on the left-hand side of the wall. In the left-hand side, tension will be developed, and because of that, cracks may develop in the wall, generally at the bottom of the wall. So this is a plastic hinge generated in the wall. We shall study about plastic hinge in some new video. So here is the practical example of a shear wall building. You can see these are the shear wall here. This vertically standing wall is shear wall. There is some opening in the wall, and this is shear wall, and then rest are the columns, and there can be beams, slabs and other elements, frame elements. So this is our shear wall. In this drawing, schematically the shear walls are shown by black planes. So these are all shear walls you see in different orientations, and along with that you have the beams and column framework, which is the frame system. The shear wall disposition is shown here by another figure. All these elements with the red top are the shear walls, having different orientations and different configuration. And rest of the pedestals are the columns. a shear wall building with a skyscraper like large height or high-rise building is shown here. This is a shear wall here. These are also shear walls with opening in between. Here it is the shear wall. So what materials can be used for construction of the shear wall? The materials can be reinforced concrete system, then brick masonry, timber, steel, and also you can use composite material. Now, how do you place the shear wall in the plan of the building so that it is safe against earthquake or any other lateral force? So here are some guidelines available. Shear wall is to be placed symmetrically in the plan. If it is not symmetrically placed, it will create torsion in the system and it will damage the system. Shear wall is to be placed along both directions of the building plan, because earthquake may come from any direction and the building plan has measured two directions, short direction and long direction. So shear walls are to be placed along both the measured directions of the building. Shear wall is to be placed at the periphery of the building. If it is placed at the periphery of the building, it gives the maximum efficiency of the shear wall. Here we have considered a plan of a building, and now let us see how to place the shear walls systematically and to avoid torsion and to avoid other ill effects. So we say we provide two shear walls at the two ends here, as given the third point here, it should be at the periphery. So we have put two walls in the periphery, but this will create asymmetry unless we provide shear walls also at the bottom of the plan. So we provide shear walls at the bottom. Now the shear wall disposition is symmetrical, but it is symmetrical only along the long direction of the plan. So you require also walls on the short direction. So we place the short directional walls, say, here like this, but this will create asymmetry again because on the other side there is no short directional wall. So we provide another two walls here. Now all the walls are placed symmetrically and it will not create any extra torsion. However, you can also place shear wall like this in between. In between, you can design it accordingly and you can place it. And you can also put it like a concentric box. This is automatically created in case of the lift. The lift has a box where the shear walls are there, or concrete walls are there on the all sides with opening in one side. So this can be the placement of the shear walls. Now shear walls, different sections can be provided. Schematic sections are shown here, box, I section, L, I section with flange, T section, Y section, channel section, like that. So these are all shear wall plans shown here of different categories. Based on the requirement of the structure, you can select any kind of configuration. Now in the masonry building also there is a shear wall. This can look contradictory because masonry is brittle material, so how it will work as a shear wall? Actually, the concept of shear wall is not in structural element, whether it is RCC or whether it is some other thing. It is the question of resisting the lateral load in its own plane. So if anything, like even mud wall resists the lateral load in its plane, it will be called a shear wall. So we have considered a masonry shear wall plan here. Suppose the north and south directions are like this, NS, and earthquake is taking place from the east-west direction. So earthquake is taking place in this direction. Now the walls which are parallel to the earthquake will be called as shear wall. This wall is shear wall now, this one is shear wall. The other two are not shear wall for the time being when earthquake is taking place from left to right. Now let us see when it changes and earthquake takes place from the north-south direction. So in that case, the walls in the direction of the earthquakes are the left one and the right one. So this will be the shear wall as per our terminology. Now shear wall construction in RCC will look like this. You have the vertical steel and you have the horizontal steel. The vertical steel will carry the bending moment because it is a cantilever system we have already discussed. Vertical steel will be resisting the bending moment and the horizontal steel will be resisting the shear because you have shear also arising in the building and this will be resisted in its own plane through this horizontal steel. So generally two layers of steel will be provided here. You can see on the back side one layer and the front side another layer. Generally two layers will be provided unless the thickness is less than 150 millimeter. The thickness of shear wall varies from say 150 millimeter to say about 350 millimeter to even it may be 400 millimeter. In this slide we are showing RC shear wall. At the bottom we have shown RC shear wall sectional plan, and the top we have shown the sectional elevation. So we have two layers of steel in the section on the two sides. In the vertical elevation you can see some steel are running vertically and some steel are running horizontally. The vertical steel are meant for the cantilever bending action, and the horizontal steel are for resisting the shear forces in the wall. The section shows without any boundary element. What is boundary element is illustrated in this figure. At the ends we have put column like section here at the two ends. These are called boundary elements. The purpose of this is to enhance the performance of the wall and to strengthen it. The advantages of providing boundary elements are like this. It prevents cracking of the edge of the wall. In the earlier slide we have seen the convex side of the wall under bending undergoes tension, and as it is concrete it will fail in tension and it will crack. So boundary elements will prevent that cracking. Boundary element increases the strength of the wall. It increases ductility of the wall. Ductility is very important aspect of design, so that your structure is not failing at small displacement. It helps the beams to meet wall. Suppose you have some beams meeting in the wall, so instead of the beam coming directly over the wall, the beams can come over the boundary element, which is like a column. And beam to column connection is as usual, which is easy in detailing and in construction. This slide is showing that the boundary element can be embedded inside the shear wall. So here there is no bulging at the end of the shear wall, and the boundary elements are embedded within the shear wall, thickness of the shear wall itself. Shear wall types are, we have material types we have discussed. So this is the cantilever type. Then you can have with wall opening. So openings are required for say ventilation, etc., for air, for sunlight. So these are the openings provided in the wall. So you have to take appropriate precautions in the design and in detailing so that it is not breaking near the openings. And sometimes we have two shear walls put side by side and they are connected by beams. So I can connect this by beams. These red lines are the beams. So these beams are called coupling beams because they are coupling the two shear walls side by side, and that's why it is called coupled shear wall. Now there is another term, the squat shear wall. What it is? When the length to height or height to length ratio is less, in that case it is squat. So what is the requirement? If the height to length of the wall ratio lies between 2 to 3, it will be called a squat wall. Now what is height? This is a vertical one is height, and the horizontal dimension of the wall, horizontal longer dimension, is called the length of the wall given by LW. Height of the wall you can give by H or HW. So squat walls are sometimes required in building due to structural requirements, and you have to take adequate detailing requirements, satisfy detailing requirements and design requirements, so that such kinds of walls are also safe. Now there is a very important term called the frame shear wall building, which is a combination of shear wall and frames. For example, in the left hand figure, this is a shear wall here. This vertical one is also a shear wall at the edge, and remaining are columns and beams. So this is called the frame system. Here you can see one shear wall, second shear wall, third shear wall. And then you have the column system and the beam system, so which are part of frame. So there is one side the shear wall is there, another side the frame is there, both are integrally built. So this is called frame shear wall building. We shall be studying this building more in detail in coming videos, and they have special behavior, what is called frame wall interaction, that also we shall discuss in coming videos. So because of the frame wall interaction, the whole system changes the curvature at some height. So if it was having a tension on the left side, in the other side it may be tension on the right side. So it changes curvature, and this is the point of inflection of the wall. So how to calculate the point of inflection, we shall see in some coming video. Now, what are the advantages of shear wall? Why do we go for shear wall? It can resist large horizontal earthquake force or wind force. It is easy to detail and construct the shear wall, though it is so useful, the detailing is not so tough. It is simply like a column with a width longer. It reduces lateral sway of the building, thereby eliminating chance of damage. Because, as I've said earlier, the shear wall provision increases the rigidity of the building. As a result, the deflection of the system will be reduced, and so damage will be reduced. It is cost effective. It can dissipate large amount of energy through hysteresis during earthquake, because during earthquake, a lot of energy will be absorbed by your system depending on its stiffness and mass. So this is to be dissipated properly, and through hysteresis, it can dissipate the energy, and because the wall is having large resisting capacity, bending moment to the tune of say 10,000 kilonewton meter, so it will be also dissipating energy proportionally very high. Now, is there any disadvantage of the shear wall? Yes, there are some. So it blocks sunlight and air from outside the building because it is completely dark. There is no opacity in the wall. Openings are generally avoided. Its damage is not easily repairable. In most cases, it may not be repairable at all. Foundation of shear wall needs extra attention because the lot of overturning moment comes because of rigidity. It attracts a lot of force and a lot of bending moment which will try to overturn the system. So it requires a strong foundation to resist that overturning moment. Improper location of wall leads to torsional effect. As we have discussed in the previous slide, it should be disposed symmetrically in both the directions of the building. Unless it is done so, there will be torsional effect in the building and it will invite damage. Thank you very much for watching the video. Please subscribe the video, like and share. Put your inquiry in the comment box. I shall be glad to answer your queries at the best of my level. Thank you, and see you again in the next video.